Internet CD Projekt Red says ray tracing is not a gimmick. Hey Internet, Gordon Young with PC World. I'm here at GDC with Kuba Napic. He is the VP Global Art Director of CD Projekt Red, and we just went through a great demo of path tracing that's gonna come soon for Cyberpunk. But the important thing, I wanna talk to an artist. So he is the artist that has created the beautiful Night City in Cyberpunk, and he's gonna explain to us why path tracing is awesome and why you should stop calling ray tracing a gimmick.
Yes, I'm gonna give it a shot.
Okay.
All right, so why it isn't a gimmick, or why do we differentiate the name of it?
Well, why is it so amazing? Because his words, you said that path tracing is Christmas for artists.
It is. You know, ray tracing was already used quite broadly actually in game industry for a couple of years. And it is actually helping. It is helping. That's why I wouldn't call it a gimmick. It is actually helping to solve certain problems, quality problems and visual problems in the games. And for some players, you know, let's honestly say visuals are also extremely important. And many, many players actually play games also because of the visuals, or in some cases because of the visuals mostly. So, you know, it is important. But path tracing is like a next step of evolution of that, because ray tracing is solving certain individual elements of the equation of the rendering, lighting. So it fixes the shadows, or it fixes the reflections, or it fixes the ambient occlusion. All those elements, layers are stuck up on top of each other and generate the final image. Well, path tracing is like, let's not do all those individual layers. Let's just do one proper unified rendering. And the outcome of it is that the image that you're getting is way more balanced, it's way more accurate, and it's way more beautiful in the end. And you get enormously beautiful graphics in your game that looks very much like the rendering in the films or animated films in the past, because it is, you know, the technology is actually very close to the one used in the films and in animation in a couple of years already. So it is, you know, but you're playing it in real time.
Right, and earlier you mentioned like pre-baked lighting models.
Yes.
You have a very limited amount of light sources, right?
Yes, well, the budget, the bigger the game is, the smaller the budget, but we call it budget in game dev. Budget is just how much stuff you can actually put in a game and still make it performant. That's the budget. So when you are relying on a more classical approach, you're always playing back and forth with the budget. So how many lights can actually cast shadow? How far the global illumination can be counted? This kind of stuff. And with path tracing and RTXDI, which are some of the systems that we're using, you actually kind of flip the table a little bit in the approach, because with the solution that we came up with NVIDIA, well, we didn't come up with, we worked on this, but implementing it to Cyberpunk, we actually totally take out the budgeting of the lighting, and we have unlimited amount of lights casting shadow and generating in-light illumination until the horizon. They all generate perfect, beautiful gradients and super balanced image. So, yeah, the beauty is there. The beauty is there, and realism is there. And for our game, you know, the realism was always a very important factor and as a backdrop for our mature storytelling in a game.
Okay. And so, basically, if you already own Cyberpunk,
yes,
you say you play through an ultra. When the tech demo comes out, it's worth playing through again.
Yes. We are releasing it on the 11th of April. So very soon, as a technology preview. It's very important that we call it like this, because we are still working on this technology with NVIDIA, and we plan to have it more or less wrap up on our next release. But it is so cool already, it is so gorgeous to play this game already, that we figured that we will release a technology preview with a note. You guys need to be aware that it's still in the making and still a work in progress thing. And yes, if you have a powerful PC, I still need to say it is a technology of a future. But if you already have a very powerful PC, you can play it.
Okay.
It is hardware agnostic, so it doesn't really matter what kind of brand of the card you have. You just need to know that it's very powerful, honestly speaking, and you can play it.
Now, the other question I have is, as a developer, you know, you're basically doing multiple light models in a way now.
Yeah.
Do you look forward to not doing it the old method? Are we going to get to that point where you don't have to do pre-baked lighting? And
well, I think that currently we're showing it as a glimpse of a future, as a glimpse of what we as a developers would love to have. You know, we would love to be unlimited by the budgets, by the technology in delivering what we think is absolutely gorgeous stuff for the players. So it is a glimpse of a future. We still have to, you know, support old pipelines and old hardware platforms. So it's not like it's flipping the pipeline today, but we think that it will flip the pipelines of the future dramatically. It will make it way easier to make games visually. It will make way nicer games overall, and it will make developers happier. And we'll manage to actually shorten the time span needed for delivering a game. Because if it's quicker, if you can quickly generate the final look you're looking for, you know, it makes the production quicker.
Right. So 5 or 6 years, I mean, we're looking forward-looking, you know, we'll get rid of the older models, but right now.
Hopefully.
But you prefer, obviously, the look of the newer PathTrace model over.
You know, there are many ways of solving the rendering problems. You know, there are many other solutions in the market, like Lumen in Epic, which is also amazing. So, you know, there are many technologies that try to solve that. This is one of them, and this is definitely something that this approach is definitely something we'd love to use in the future as our main approach.
Oh, okay. And last question, when is it going to come out? When can people get it?
People can get it on the 11th of April, so very, very soon. It's a free patch for PC. It's a technology preview, let me say it again.
Cool, and definitely you want high-end hardware for that. So.
Yes, you want to have very high-end hardware for that.
Cool, well, you know what? I love high-end hardware, and I like it when people take advantage of it, so
yeah.
Thank you for the talk. Our next guest is Paul Kozlowski. He is with NVIDIA, a senior developer technology engineer. That sounds really fancy to me. Can you tell me what that role means at NVIDIA?
Yes, so yeah, in the kind of like the dev tech, we call ourselves, we're kind of like being, we're just like group of rendering engineers, and we are being deployed to different, you know, game devs.
Okay.
Kind of like support them in integrating some of the real-time, you know, graphics algorithms of the future, like recently path tracing.
Okay.
In Cyberpunk. Yeah.
So and again, you know, the path tracing demo that we saw here, pretty awesome, by the way, coming out pretty soon. But can you tell me what NVIDIA technologies are implemented in the version that we're seeing?
Right.
That you're taking advantage of, I guess, on your parts?
Yeah, so the entire idea of like, you know, pushing the real-time path tracing definitely relies on RTX DI for computing all the direct illumination. And then we're using, you know, path tracing to compute the indirect part of the render equation, let's say. To make it performant enough, you definitely need, you know, the 40 series GPUs. Mainly because they are the most powerful. They do support DLSS 3, you know, the super res that was there already, but we also now have frame generation, which is also a very important bit of the puzzle. And SER, which is shader execution reordering, which is basically like helps you know, execute incoherent workloads like path tracing, which is full of them, in kind of like performant manner on the GPU.
So, you know, I think I saw this at Computex 3 years ago, Quake 2, RTX,
yep.
Fully path traced game. Pretty cool, but that is a 23-year-old game. How in the hell are you able to do a AAA title with path tracing now and still be playable, frame rates?
Be playable, yes, on the latest hardware. So we got the new hardware, we got the new magical DLSS 3, and we got, you know, working with CD Projekt for many years, we already had all the building blocks through ray tracing. We already had BVH. We already had, you know, material system visible to ray tracing pipeline. And now we just like kept building on this, and all these things came together that we have enough performance. We have amazing algorithms like RTX DI. And all these things together just made it possible, I guess.
So the hardware
is AAA content that we are able to pull this off.
Can you say what level of graphics card you're going to need for this? Because I think everybody's going to assume 4090, but...
Right. So we are aiming for, you know, a good experience on 40 series GPUs across the board.
Okay. We talked with CD Projekt Red. He was super excited, you know, as a visual artist creating these worlds. He was very excited about this. this move? And from your point of view, from a hardware side, mm-hmm. do you think we're going to get to the point where most games might be path traced, or at least developers might consider that as the first option?
Yes, I strongly believe so. You know, like, this is an algorithm that's been used in offline world for years, right? And yeah. there's a reason for that. It's like, it's just one of the best things we have to simulate the real life lightning.
Right.
And just being able now to finally bring it to the games, to the real time, I would say, why bother with something else if you can have this?
True, true. And I guess, you know, again, the developers are saying it's just so easy, so much easier in some ways.
Yeah, it's, you know, predictable, it's kind of instant. You don't need to, you know, deal with setting up all your probes and whatnot. Just like set up your geometry, set up your lights, set up your camera, and it kind of just works.
Yeah, and you know, that's something I think it needs to be said a little louder, is that this is a model that has been used in the offline world. Yep. What do you mean by the offline world?
Like, you know, movies, when, you know, rendering of single frame can take, you know, they have unlimited time, right?
Right.
Can run minutes, hours, days. And so, yeah, that's the offline world, basically, like CG animated movies.
Right. So
essentially, by offline, I guess, or not real time, not interactive, means you have predefined set of frames and you just have to make sure that each of them statically looks amazing.
Right.
With interactive entertainment like games, when you have input from the player, you never know what will be my next frame. And we have only, like, you know, 16 milliseconds, let's say, to generate that frame. So, a slightly different problem.
Right, and we're just getting a step closer to, every day we get a step closer to it, right?
Correct, so, yep.
And it, again, it is a tech preview, tech demo, so not everything is gonna be fully
correct.
Nailed down initially.
We'll keep working on it and keep making it even more amazing.
Cool. Well, thanks for joining us. Again, come back to PC World's channel for more videos and click that subscribe and click the bell.